Okay, Monty, we have your transmission out and disassembled. I'm going to go over a few things with you that we found. We'll start here with a pan. See if I can get a close-up on this. You got a rag? And all this... Oh, no, move that light. Ouch. All this metal right here, it's just piled up super thick around that magnet. We've gone through this thing and looked around here, right here around the where the pump is. There's a bushing in here that rides around the torque converter. This bushing has failed and has wiped out the hub on this converter. It's all grooved and everything right here. All this metal, we went through the whole transmission and everything was okay, with the exception of all that metal being embedded into the clutches here, which will have to be replaced. But all that metal is coming through this torque converter. This torque converter has actually failed, and this is where all the metal is coming from. So what we're going to have to do is, this is going to take a rebuild with a new torque converter, a few electronics. This electronic solenoid block here is electromagnetic, and it's full of that metal, so this will have to be replaced. The cooler system on this will have to be flushed thoroughly. I'll show you that here in just a minute. But as I suspected, very minimal damage, just a few things. So I'll have the estimate written up for you and attach this as a PDF. Review the information and get back to me and let me know what you would like to do. Thanks, Monty.
Okay, this is our hot flush machine. And it's not hooked up to your car, but it's going to be, and this is just an example to show you how it works. As you can see on the side here, the hot flush is hooked up to shop air pressure. That runs over there to the lift. And then these hoses are hooked to the vehicle. And what happens is this runs heated transmission fluid through the transmission cooler system in the vehicle. And what it does, this heated fluid gets up to about 190 degrees. Right now, it's only at about 179 degrees. But it'll get up to 190, and we usually set the timer for 3 hours. This one is currently set for 1 hour. We'll bump this up. But 3 hours is a normal time that we run it. And it runs heated fluid for 3 seconds, and then for half a second, it blasts 150 pounds of shop air the opposite way. And that's the pulsation that you see and hear. And right now, this one, it'll get up to about 60 pounds. Right now, it's running about 20 pounds, but it'll get up here to 50 or 60 pounds. And then it also measures volume here. Right now, this is flowing about 5 gallons a minute is what that's flowing. I don't know if you see that with the glare on it or not. But see if I get a better shot of that. Where that orange line is, that's right at 5 gallons a minute. And it's heated fluid, and it gets all that metal and clutch debris out. This is a state-of-the-art machine. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. That's the hot flush machine, and that's what's going to be hooked up to your car to get all that contamination out of the cooler.